Hi everyone, this is Fazluddin. Today I'm going to talk about RabbitMQ, which is a message broker. It will be used in application to application communication and message transformation. Like if you want to send any message to one application or another application, we can use RabbitMQ, which is used vastly in many applications and very popular in current market. As part of this session, I'm going to cover overview of RabbitMQ and exchange models, which are supported through AMQP protocol, and required softwares to set up the RabbitMQ, and sample program. I'm going to show some sample program, how the publisher and the consumer will work. Okay, let's start with the overview. RabbitMQ is a message broker, which I told already, and it gives a common platform to send and receive messages. Messages are safe and placed to live until received. Means it has a durability feature through which we can store the messages until it will deliver to the next endpoint. Okay, RabbitMQ performance with reliability, including and delivery acknowledgements, publisher confirmation, and high availability. These are the main features which will attract to use RabbitMQ. Okay, and messages are routed through exchanges before arriving at a queue. So there are exchanges will be used to send the messages through queue. Okay, that is what it means. RabbitMQ comes with several built-in exchange types. We will see those exchange types in later slides. Complex routing. You can bind exchanges together over even write your own exchange type as a plugin. We can write our custom exchange types and we can use as a plugin in RabbitMQ, which are by default some exchange types are there. So if you want to create your own exchange, you can create and you can use as a plugin. That flexibility also provided in RabbitMQ. Several RabbitMQ servers on a local network can be clustered together. So if you want to have a clustered environment, if you out throughput will be more, and if you want to increase the load, and if you want to handle those load, you can go with a clustered environment. You can configure with RabbitMQ servers, multiple RabbitMQ servers. Queues can be mirrored across several machines in a cluster, and ensuring that even in the event of hardware failure, means if there is a cluster environment, it's always like if one hardware failure is happen, still your messages are routed through proper channels, and we can store and we can redirect that messages to the different queues, and we can handle those queues and we can deliver at the end point. That is what it means. Like if there is a hardware failure also, you no need to worry, and we can safely route that messages. RabbitMQ supports messages over a variety of messaging protocols. For example, AMQP and STOMP and MQTT and HTTP. Let's move to the next slide. Now we are going to talk about exchange models, which are supported through AMQP. First one is a default exchange. The default exchange is a direct exchange with no name. Like if you were not provided any exchange while sending any message, okay, through publisher, it will create a default exchange, AMQP default exchange, which will be used to pre-declared by the broker. Okay, it is pre-declared broker, and we can use that exchange to get that messages. If you see in the below the flow chart, if I have different publishers and subscribers here, and if you see here, like what is the configuration, it will have exchange as blank and key is general, and payload is XYZ. What is the payload? Payload is a message what we are going to send through queues, and default exchange is suitable for point-to-point communication between endpoints. Okay, and if you see here, AMQP default exchange is created, and through that we have given key as a general. Okay, when you subscribe, when this key will be accessed by subscriber, we will have key name, okay, which is pointed to the default exchange, and through that we can consume that messages, and we can use that message for the next process. If you see AMQP default is a system exchange, we'll call it as a system exchange also. Let's move to the next exchange. This is next exchange is a direct exchange. In direct exchange, delivers messages to queue based on the message routing key. Here we will have a keys, different keys. Okay, and here we will mention a exchange type is a direct. And if you see here, we will have a different key in the diagram. If you observe the diagram closely, like we will have a Mumbai key and Bangalore key. Okay, we are sending the message to that through the broker, direct exchange broker. And here if you have a different queues, which is one is a Mumbai key related queue and Bangalore key related queue, and consumers to consumers are there, which has pointed to the particular queues using the keys. The consumers related to Mumbai key will be consumed all the messages through Mumbai key, and Bangalore consumers will consume all the messages through Bangalore key queue. This is how this direct exchange will work. And let's move to the next slide. Fan out exchange. The fan out exchange routes messages to all of the queues that are bound to it, and the routing key is ignored. Okay, here we don't have a routing key. All the messages through routed through exchange. Okay, we will have an exchange, and whatever the subscribers configured with that exchange, that can be used the default queues whatever created by this exchange, and all the messages will be routed through that queues. Okay, if you see here in the configuration exchange log, we mentioned key is blank and payload is XYZ. Okay, for example, and if you see the log exchange is here, and log exchange is created error and warning queues, two queues, and the subscribers are pointed to this different queues which are created by this exchange, and those subscribers will be subscribed with this queues and consume those messages and process the next level, process to the next level. Log is a default, is a defined as a fan out exchange upon creation. Okay, and let's move to the next slide. Topic exchange. Topic exchanges routes messages to one or many queues based on matching between the message routing key. Depends upon the matching routing key. Here we will have an exchange with the matching routing key. Okay, and through that we can configure that queues and consumers, which will be consumed depends upon the matching. Okay, exchange with the particular key. If you see here, publisher is publishing through the exchange through the type of topic. Okay, and this is, we'll call it as a vehicle exchange. For example, we are taking that exam, we will have a Toyota, Nissan and all cars. Okay, Toyota cars is binded with Toyota cars key, and Nissan cars are binded with the Nissan car keys, and all cars binded with the star dot cars key. Okay, here if you see the queues, multiple queues is created as per that keys. One is Toyota cars key, cars queues, and Nissan cars queues, and all cars queues. All the consumers are pointed to different queues. Toyota cars consumer is pointed to Toyota cars queues. Nissan car consumers are pointed to Nissan cars queues, and all cars consumers, all cars queues. So this is how this process will be happen in topic exchanges. Okay, each exchange can be splitted into different keys, and different consumers can pointed to that depends upon the key combination. Okay, all the messages will be routed through particular key. Okay, next we'll move to the next exchange. Headers exchange is like it depends upon the message we will pass some header. Okay, in the header depends upon the values, whatever the header values, like X match values, depends upon that the queues will be created, and those queues will be consumed by different consumers. Okay, here if you see the multiple attributes that are more easily expressed as a message headers than the routing key. It's not depend upon the routing key, it depends upon the header message. Okay, and here if you see the publisher is publishing a message, and in the header we have a key and value. Okay, if you see xmatch is any, and xmatch any key 1 value 1 key 2 value 2 for one queue, this is the message type, and one consumer who all are having the who all are checking for this header values, those consumers will consume this queue messages. And if you see xmatch any and key 3 key 4 is there, this is the header we are passing, and consumer which are looking with this header, those messages will be passed to this consumer. The third one is similar to that, and this is the third consumer will be there, which will access depends upon the header values. Okay, so queues will be segregated depends upon the header values. Okay, these are the exchange models, four exchange models which will mostly used in the queues. Move to the next slide. Here is the requirement to configure the RabbitMQ and to use the RabbitMQ in your application. RabbitMQ is server is required, so we will install that RabbitMQ, and Erlang is required to configure the RabbitMQ, and Java to write the programming, and RabbitMQ libraries like HTTP client libraries are the RabbitMQ libraries, and we can import those libraries to support that program. Let's move to that simple program which I written. So here I have written one simple program like consumer and publisher. Okay, first I will walk through this program what I written here. Okay, publisher, I will talk about publisher, like first we'll start program will start from a publisher. So here I have written some publisher class, and here I have a queue name I declared, hello queue I have declared. And in the main method I have created a connection factory. Connection factory is to initiate the queue. Okay, and connection factory sets the local host, okay, to create the connection between the RabbitMQ server. Okay, which server we are going to access, this is a local host I installed in a local machine, and I have initiating the connection, and I'm creating a channel. And after creating a channel, using the channel, I'm creating the declaring the queue here. And here I have used one loop here to publish the messages. For example, I am publishing almost 10 messages I'm publishing, and a hello message from RabbitMQ message, some number I am printing which message I'm going to publish. And here channel basic publish, here I am using queue name. See, if you see here, first parameter is the exchange. I'm not using any exchange here, and I'm passing the message, and system.out, just I'm printing the message what I'm sending to queue. Well, this is the publisher, simple program I have written to publish the messages into the queue. And coming to the consumer, here I have written a consumer class, and queue name, whatever queue name I'm using there, same queue name I'm mentioning here. And in the main method I have created the connection factory, and what server I am accessing is the local server. And connection factory getting the connection, new connection, and create channel, I need to use the channel here. And queue declaration, I'm declaring the queue which I'm going to consume. And here this is asynchronous callback method which will listens the publisher, okay, which will listen to the broker, like how the messages will be published. Once the message is published, this consumer will continuously listen to that broker, and it will fetch the messages. Whenever the message is published into that queue, it will listen to the queue and it will get the messages. And here I am consuming all the messages here using the queue, and delivery consume tag. Okay, if you see here, I'm printing what are the messages I have consumed. Okay, channel queue I have mentioned, mean callback I have written the channel here, basic consume queue, and I'm calling this callback in this method basic consume and consume tag. Okay, Here if you see, I am delivering get body, I am taking the message and I am printing the message. Let's before starting it, I want to tell you something about management console of RabbitMQ. It's very interesting, and so whatever the messages we are publishing, whatever messages we are consuming, how many messages are in queue, all those things we can check here. It's a very good dashboard it is providing by RabbitMQ, which will come with the RabbitMQ server. Once you launch, once you install the RabbitMQ server, you can start this management console, and you can access through localhost using this port. Then you can see all the what are the messages, what are the queues are there, what are the channels are there, all those things we can see here. So let's I will run the program and I will show you what happens in the management console. So first I will run the publisher program to publish the messages. So just I will go and run this program. If you see here, I have run successfully my program. I can see 10 messages are published in the queue, and I can go and check here. If I go and check, it should number should be replicated here. How many messages are there in the queue? So it will take little bit time actually. You see here some changes are happened, and this console will refresh with every 5 seconds. So what I will do, I will just wait for some time to update this dashboard with that messages. Oh, sorry. I was running the consumer. So let's, I will stop this consumer. I will run one more time. Because of that only, I am not able to see the number here. It's already consumed, published and consumed. So let's, I will run one more time. This publisher. Now I should see that numbers here. I have published this messages. Now if I go here, I should see this number. See here. 10 messages I published. So here, I can see the messages, and if I go to the queues, I can see which queue, how many messages. If you see hello queue, if you see here, queue in the program, hello queue. So which is ideal, and 10 messages are waiting to consume. Okay, and now if I run the consumer program, then all the messages will be gone. Okay, if you run that consumer message, you won't see any messages. Within seconds, milliseconds, it will consume and reprocess. Let's run that consume program. See here, received message 1, 2, 3, 4. If I go here, see, immediately these numbers are zero. If I see here, what happened? All the messages are gone. If I go to the queue, see, hello queue, 00. So my program runs successfully and consumer is consumed all the messages what are published in the hello queue. So this is how the RabbitMQ will work, and it will consume all the messages. If I talk about this dashboard, is a pretty straightforward dashboard, and it is very helpful to check how many queues are there and what are the messages are publishing and how where the messages are stuck and which queues are not working properly. So those things we can check it here. How many exchanges are created? If you go to the exchanges dashboard, you can see the all those things. There are a lot of features in the dashboard you can go through and you can check. So how we can use this dashboard, and it is pretty useful, and memory information also it will display how much memory is it consuming. Okay, what type of exchanges, okay, like durable and different kinds of features are there. We can see all those things in dashboard, and we can create the users, multiple users to access this dashboard also. Okay, this is how the RabbitMQ will work. This is the basic RabbitMQ program which I written to give you some example. I hope you guys like this session, and you got fair idea on how the RabbitMQ will work. And now I think you can write your own program to test the RabbitMQ broker, and you can use in your future applications. Thank you so much for watching my video, and if you like my video, you can subscribe my channel Technology Adda for more videos. Okay, bye.